finally happened.
Are we? Did you? Have we? What?
What?
Greetings, movie fans. You're all very welcome to the Big Reviewski with Omniplex Cinemas and my Omnipass. My name is Eoghan Doherty, and this week we're in a rush. We don't have time for introductions. There's Justine Stafford, there's Rory Cashin, there's Paul Muir. I know that qualifies as an introduction, yeah, but it's not a real introduction.
The wave is really weird.
You started a whole show.
We never got off to that quick.
Don't like that.
Me and Justine, wave first.
No, wave normally, Justine.
See, this is the way to do it. I'm Rory and Paul. If you want to give a wee wave there as well.
What is that?
Being the queen that I am.
Not my show, pal. Anyway, really unbelievably busy show coming up. Possibly one of our busiest.
Yeah.
So many reviews to get through, so many tickets to give away, and loads of crack to be had as well. If you would like to get in touch and tell us what you're busy with.
How you wave. Thanks, that's
a good thing to do. You can tweet us at Big Reviewski, you can get in touch on Instagram, Facebook, and you can also, what else? Oh, subscribe to the show as well.
You can just ring in as well. Yeah. Like, we're sitting here live.
Yeah. waiting for that phone to ring. Any second now. If you could play, just feel like we're on like a movie-a-thon or something. There was one thing somebody mentioned. Oh, yeah. If people leave comments or like a review of the show, especially if people are listening on their popular podcast listening devices, then that helps the show.
It does.
Only if you leave like positive ones.
Yeah, positive ones, very helpful.
Very. Negative ones?
They're honest. It's only honest. Honest ones are the positive.
Okay, well, now we've discovered.
There's nothing mean to say about
now we've discovered who's been leaving all our negative. Yeah. Negative.
But he's admitted that he's lied about the negative stuff, so it's fine.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. Okay. Anyway, you can do all that stuff. For now, though, we're going to press on with the rest of the show. We'll get to the reviews, we'll get to the ticket giveaways as well. But first of all, it's time for the big question on the Big Reviewski. Now, one of our big reviews coming up later on is Zombieland Double Tap. Very excited about that.
The original one.
Yeah, the original was an absolutely super film. Bit of a sleeper hit as well. It's just like, whoa, that's a cracker.
Well, when you hear the name Zombieland, you just think, that's not great.
That is not going to be
fantastic. If you're an actor and someone's like, oh, I got the script, give it a read, and you just see the title, you're like,
nah. It seems like a game at an arcade that you'd be
Yeah.
That's what it sounds like. With a gun, and it's like,
We're going to have a full review of that later on. Mr. Palmer is going to be looking after that one. But in honor of the release of that film, I want to know what's your favorite zombie death / kill in the movies. And the meaning in this one is like, it's whether a zombie is actually killing somebody, that's fine, or whether a zombie is being killed as well. So you could interpret that whatever way you wanted. All right?
Yeah, I'm on board.
Yeah, okay. Sweet.
Death by or to zombie, got it.
Yes, yeah. Exactly.
The zombie is no longer.
He's an ex-zombie, bereft of life and death, isn't he?
You dig up.
Yeah, sweet. So do you want to hear my answer?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Edge of your seat to everybody. So I'm not the biggest horror aficionado in the world. Shock horror right there. Nor are you. Thanks.
Way to draw, really like that one.
Quickly do a panic wave.
But no, I can relate.
Yeah.
We got this in common.
There was this.
So like the zombie film that I've gone for is more in the comedy genre.
Yes.
It's a zom-com. And
it's a zom-rom-com.
A zom-rom-com, of course. And so directed by Mr. Edgar Wright, and it is, of course, Shaun of the Dead. Fantastically funny film. Just so, one of those films that's so rewatchable, like just the little details in it throughout. And the particular zombie death that I've gone for is the death of the pub owner.
Big Ed.
Or the main bar. Is that his name? Big Ed.
Big Ed.
Big Dad. And whenever he gets, come on, that's a good mark.
Why?
Your mommy says you have to be nice to me this week as well.
God damn it.
That's his mother writing that X there.
Yeah,
now.
Exactly. You know your mommy's watching and she's like, yeah.
Big Al. Sound. That was his name. Not Ed.
I was just, oh, no.
Sorry, when you were getting at the
no.
mom, I was thinking there.
You gave away the mark.
Two X's.
Oh, that's not fair. You
My mommy
me
will
up.
Not allow bad punmanship.
You
so.
Absolute.
I'm not reviewing everything.
Anyway, his death is done perfectly in time to the jukebox playing Queen's Don't Stop Me Now, and they grab anything they can get their hands on, but starting off with like the snooker cues, and they're doing it in time as well, and it's just, it's so much fun to watch. And then it was the one that stood out in the movie, even though you could obviously have any number of cool deaths from this movie. But I just, when I was watching it back, just sitting there with a big goofy smile, I was like, this is really, really enjoyable. This is a lot of fun. Plus, you get lots of blood splatter and gore and stuff as well. So we take a wee look.
Yeah.
If it doesn't work due to legal reasons with Queens, don't stop me now. This might be very short. But if not, enjoy this scene from Shaun the Dead.
Quiet, Queen Stella! We have a situation! I know! Fuck this!
Hey, 2 seconds!
Quiet!
Edgar Wright is a genius.
Lovely man as well. You met him, didn't you?
For Baby Driver, yeah. That's right.
Seems very cool.
Yeah, we're good pals.
That's why you picked it.
That's why, but yeah, he asked me to. Rory, what did you go for?
I went for another English zombie movie. It is 28 weeks later.
The pregnancy one. Thanks. It's just because it has the word weeks in it. I don't know.
He's still punching down.
Yeah, really? Punching really low today. I haven't had any food today yet. Yeah, I'm starving.
I like 28 Weeks Later, Rory. So which one was it?
Yes. It was. Yeah. It's the opening scene where Robert Carlyle and his wife and child have been like hiding from the zombies. And then they find them. And instead of trying to save his wife and child, he just bails.
He does a runner.
That's a Rory Cashin.
Yeah, that's a real that's Rory Cashin.
That's what they get. It's like, if you can't keep up, that's on you.
Oh my God, Robert Carlyle or C. Rory Cashin.
It's based on
it's me. The Illuminati.
It's based on yeah, and he just bails. And the whole thing is like, it goes back and forth between Robert Carlyle and his wife. And the wife is like, are you actually going to leave me
Her
here?
Her face.
And it pays off so fantastically later on in the movie. A spoiler to how old is this film now? It's old enough.
It's a fair bit.
That she comes back and he's forced to kind of deal with her again. And it doesn't end well for anyone. But yeah, just the opening scene. I remember just like the kind of psychological horror of it where you're like, you can't be sure that isn't what you do in the face of something terrible happening. And you're like, what? I'd like to think that I'd like to, no one here,
would
but
you? No,
I'd save other people.
Like, to the four of us, right now, there's a zombie apocalypse, the door bursts open. Alan, unsigned, hello, we love you to pieces, Fiona as well. But if they were zombies.
Yeah. Well, at the door, there's only one, like, there's nowhere else to go. If so they came in the door, we're... That's
what
it.
Are we doing? What's our tactic here? We're throwing
I'm picking Justine up.
We're using
human shield.
Yeah. Justine, yeah.
Human shield.
You're the smallest of three of us. We're using
human shield. And then if you get in his way, he's stabbing you with the pen.
Yeah, I've got my hammer pen.
Yeah. No bother. These are pointier and sharper than you think
they
are.
Like throwing stars.
Yeah, exactly.
Polite wave then at the end.
Okay, so we're surviving the zombie apocalypse together.
Together.
Together,
that's key.
But without Justine,
because she's just like, at this point. I'm so on board with this. I'm like, yeah, that's
makes
great
sense.
Yeah, use me, that's fine.
Yeah. So here is a proper traumatizing clip from 28 weeks later. Us.
Help us! Don!
the music that they used in that particular clip, which they used in the first one, 28 Days Later, and it's been used in so many different trailers and probably other movies as well. What do you call the guy? Did it John Murphy or somebody like that anyway? But it said that when they keep down, and you're just like, the tension's rising and rising. So, no, that's a cracking clip. And I just, heartbreaking for the wee boy and the mammy. Okay.
But good that Danny Boyle said he's going back to for the third part of this.
Yeah.
Say that, so looking forward to that.
Quality. God, that's slightly traumatized by that one.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not as funny as Shaun of the Dead.
No.
Worst comedy ever. Justine, what did you go for?
Well, it's funny you asked that.
Zombie Gallagher Brothers.
It's finally happened. It's finally happened.
What?
It's just a crossover episode. Yeah, I went for the exact same clip from Shaun of the Dead.
Like, same movie.
Same clip.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
That just shows how little I...
Yeah, it shows both of you.
Zombie
really movies.
One zombie movie's ever been made.
Or somebody's cheating from each other's work and, like, the teacher knows. It's one or the other.
Just don't make enough copies.
But this was your question. Why would you pick this question if you don't like zombie movies?
I just thought with, like, Zombieland coming out as well. Actually, some brilliant ones in Zombieland. Should have gone for one of those. No, but this is understandable.
Yeah.
We both prefer comedy to zombies.
Yeah, and we like music. Because the thing I loved about this clip was banging it to the beat, like.
Yeah, that's it.
Deadly. And then this, because it's the, I love this whole trilogy, though, the Cornetto thing, and then this is the Strawberry one, and I love the three films, so.
Perfect. Let's take another look at my favourite clip.
I don't know. Tonight, I'm gonna have myself.
Who the hell put this on? Some random.
For fuck's sake.
Okay, Diane, get Mum somewhere safe. David, kill the Queen. What's the jukebox? Liz, Ed, grab some weaponry.
What about a rifle?
It's not real. Cocktails.
What do you mean?
The flaming spirits, Trambuie, Sambuca, Brandy, get a racket. Light it. What? The whole place could go up.
What then?
How about pool?
Okay, John, it's time at the bar. You see him smiling through the sky like a tiger,
defying the laws of gravity. Yeah. Apologies there if you came to the Big Reviewski looking for some variety or original thinking, because we've just picked the exact same answer.
It's better the second time round.
I was dying to watch that clip again within 2 minutes of the first time. Yeah, 100%. Paul, what did you go for?
I feel like Rory's going to kill every single person in this room right now.
Like, have you gone for 28 weeks later?
No, I went for Shaun the Dead.
Oh my God. Same scene.
And like, at least I have no excuse because I'm not a horror wuss like you. I've seen like Romero's original trilogy all the way up to Zombieland 2. I love them. But I genuinely think my favourite zombie kill isn't Shaun Dead. It's not the scene, thank Christ, that the ones you were talking about.
Come on, get with the party.
Something.
It's the girl in the garden when Shaun and him and Ed first discover him for the first time, and they're like, oh my God, how we killed him. And then they fling the record, and then they go through all the discs. They're like, no, not Purple Rain, not the Batman soundtrack. Because that was the moment when it kind of, you always have those moments in films where you're like, oh, I understand exactly what this film is now.
Yeah.
So I think it's about 15, 20 minutes in, and I was like, oh, it's funny. It's like, oh, this is absolutely brilliant now. And then from there on in, I just started laughing at everything, laughed my ass off. I even remember exactly where I was when I saw it. It was one of those films, 15 years old now.
Whoa. Is it?
Yeah, that old,
boy.
So this is Shaun and Ed being very flippant with their record collection.
Flippant.
Hey. Oh, no, that's the second album I ever burned!
Now, some of these are limited.
What was that?
I think it was Blue Monday.
Man, that was the original press out.
For fuck's sake.
Purple Rain.
No.
Sign of the Times.
Definitely not.
The Batman soundtrack.
Throw it. Okay. Oh, Dire Straits.
Throw it.
Oh, Stone Roses.
No. Same coming.
I like it.
Ah, oh, Sade.
That's Liz's.
Yeah, but she did dump you.
Oh. Oh,
fuck, there's some girl in the shed.
He said it was locked.
Which one's your one, girl or bloke?
The first one.
Rory, I can't believe you ruined the big question this week by not picking a clip from Shaun of the Dead.
Mm-hmm.
Did you not hear the question? The question was, with Zombieland Double Tap being released this week, what is your favourite zombie killed slash death from Shaun of the Dead?
Was that what it was?
It's written right there. Look, yeah, don't read it. It's fine.
Sorry,
just trust me.
It's embarrassing.
That's my bad. My concern is that like people listening or watching will think they've accidentally hit the rewind button and are just watching the same thing over and over again.
Yeah.
But that's not the case. It's just you're all very unimaginative.
No, I think it's like we've got similar tastes. That's
the
okay.
The thing is, I had a very small pool to work with because I've seen very, very few horror films. So
also
that
me.
Narrows...
Yeah,
that narrows my selection process.
Should have went for like Dawn of the Dead in the helicopter or something like that. That would have been cooler.
Well, yeah, man, it gets pulled apart.
Yeah, we can have
the reason I didn't pick that one is because it's actually too violent to show.
What, in Shaun of the Dead?
No, the...
Get away from Shaun the Dead. Move past it.
Thought you meant the bit where Dylan Bourne gets pulled apart.
Well, that's an homage to the...
Oh, another film paid homage to Shaun of the Dead.
Do you want to throw it?
We're moving on from the big question before somebody actually dies.
Oh yeah.
It's time for the big trailer, and this is a trailer for a brand new film that was released 15 years ago. It's Shaun of the Dead. It's over to Justine Stafford for this week's big trailer.
Yes. So moving onwards. Oh, Clue.
We don't know what it is yet. We don't know what it is yet. What is
the literal name of the film?
This film is called Onward. I would be great at a quiz, wouldn't I?
Thank God you don't do the high clue. The answer is...
Yeah, it's a good thing. So this is Chris Pratt and Tom Holland. I think this looks very, very cute. It's also scary when I see that the release date is 6th of March 2020. Just saying 2020 and seeing that that's going to be a year now. It's pretty crazy. So this looks like a very, very cute film where two brothers basically turn 16 and their mother gives them this present and their father passed away when they were very, very young. And it's this kind of wand that they're able to bring back their father, meet him for one more day. Then it gets a little kind of twisted in that they're trying to bring him back, but they don't really know the magic of how to bring him back, and they bring back just his torso.
His
lower torso.
Torso. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
His leg torso. That's his biological name.
Yes. And the rest of the film is like, can we get all of him back?
His upper torso.
His upper torso, yeah.
So we've got Chris Pratt and Tom Holland reunited.
Taking a little step away from Marvel.
The Marvel Cinematic
still
Universe.
Still Disney, though.
Still going to make the money.
Yeah, those guys are
and it's,
really
signed still going to be
there.
Good.
Julie Louis-Dreyfus is the man.
Oh, amazing. Ooh. Brilliant.
I love Seinfeld and Veep and stuff.
So we've got a wee clip here of Onward, the brand new trailer for that film that's coming out in 2020.
2020 vision.
Is a phrase that has the numbers 2020 in it.
This spell brings him back. For one whole day, Dad will be back.
What? Back? Like back to life? That's not possible.
It is with this.
I'm gonna meet Dad.
Whoa, feet!
It's getting harder to hold!
Just legs! I definitely remember Dad having a top part.
Oh, what did I do? Hi.
We only have 24 hours to bring the rest of him back.
Until then, ta-da!
Oh, that's great! Dad, you look just like I remember.
Star-Lord and Spider-Man together again, and Veep.
Vice President.
Another superhero as well. I think it looks like very a lot fun. Of fun, definitely. Yeah. And it's Pixar, so you can't go wrong,
can't
usually.
Go wrong.
And the last time Pixar did the family stuff was Coco, which broke me. So, like, all for that.
Every single one. Coco was beautiful as well, 100%. And this looks like another brilliant world that they've created.
Yeah.
Trolls,
I love the
and
rabid
fairies.
Unicorns.
Yeah, exactly, because everyone has the. the perception of like, oh, rabbits and unicorns and they're so cute and everything. And here they look like just like wild packs of stray dogs, basically. Yeah. So no, all on board for that.
As Rory said, sequel name is right there.
Is it?
This Upward. Is Onward.
Upward.
Upward.
Boom.
Okay.
Come on. Come on, mate.
It's good.
Come on, mate.
Write this up.
Still reeling from your class 2020 line earlier on.
My mammy said you have to be nicer to me as well. Yeah. So.
In hindsight, it was actually a really good joke.
I like that one. Don't mark it down. I have some time for that.
Anyway, we're moving swiftly on because we've got a really busy show. We've got no time for faffing. Up next, there's a brand new... Or foofing. Sorry, so that's out next year, 6th of March, sorted.
6th of March, 2020.
Okay.
Yeah.
Boom. what are you writing?
None, mate.
much sooner than 6th of March 2020 is this week, and Dark Lies the Island is out this week. It's a brand new Irish film.
Seamless.
Starring, thank you, Pat Shortt and Eddie Murphy's brother Charlie Murphy from Love Hate. Palmer, you had the chance to meet the stars of the film, but before we get stuck into the interview, here's a little clip from this brand new film.
My daughter wasn't the first one that leg turned into a spacer. There was a wicked old draw off it always. Turned half the place crooked in the head. This is Daddy Mannion. I married the man.
Are you going to humiliate me, Sarah?
I know, yeah. Tell me about it. Martin Mannion, the younger of Daddy's two sons by the first old bat. God rest her. Poor Martin wasn't setting the world on fire.
Mr. Mannion, I'm from the Organic Certification Board.
The older son was my true love. Doggy Mannion.
Too much love in me heart. Dougie Mannion's only problem.
And he believes in first love.
So that's the trailer, Dark Lies the Island. Very dark comedy directed by Ian Fitzgibbon and written by Ken Barry, the playwright. Charlie Murphy plays a young wife married to a man who is kind of the like mayor slash entrepreneur slash owner of this small town that's based kind of an amalgamation of Sligo, Leitrim, Roscommon, that area in West Ireland. And Charlie Murphy has dealings with his two sons. I'm not going to give away everything yet, but she's
but I will
tied.
Give away everything.
She's tied to the family. Okay. So that's it.
Okay. So you got a brilliant Irish cast here. Mm. Pat Shortt, of course. Always very funny. Charlie Murphy, super actor as well, that has been seen most recently in Peaky Blinders.
Peaky Blinders 71, she was great in as well.
And then Mo Dunford, friend of the show, Mo. And Mr. Peter Coonan as well.
And Tommy Tiernan
as well.
Yeah. And Pat Shortt. Oh, yeah. We named him.
And Charlie Murphy.
And Shaun of the Dead. Is anyone mentioned Shaun of the Dead?
Yeah. Here's a clip from Shaun of the Dead. But yeah, so you were sitting down with Charlie and Pat to have a wee chat about the movie. So
and I had to ask because, okay, we all come up with our own questions in these interviews. But there was one question. Whenever I found out the character name for Pat Shortt, I just felt like Rory would never look me in the eye if I didn't ask him this. You do know the character's name?
So who does he play?
He plays Daddy Mannion.
Oh my God!
There is a character called Daddy Mannion.
Daddy Mannion. So hold on a second. So his actual character name officially is Daddy.
He is Daddy Mannion.
Okay.
Charlie Murphy's character.
Kevin Barry's been watching the Big Reviewski. Yeah. So she's Mammy Mannion. And he's Daddy Mannion.
No, yeah, I got it. Yeah, I just don't feel well.
So you were asking him about why Rory pukes.
I just had to ask. So it's a strong name.
It really is.
So I just had to ask him.
I'm a big fan.
Of course you were.
So let's see. Let's see what Daddy had to say. Oh.
Yeah. It's a great character name. But that's Kevin Barry's writing is all like that. And these characters, I mean, Dog Mannion and stuff. Doggy, I mean, that's a doggy. That's a brilliant name as well.
Said with no irony at all. Yeah. I just love it.
Oh, it's as rough as BJ's. Do you know, that's the and dark as that. And that's what's great about it. You know?
So, Rory, how do you feel that there's a character in the world called Daddy Mannion?
I feel like Eoghan Doherty may have written the script for this one. This is my horror.
This is my alter ego. So.
And his two sons are Doggy Mannion, played by Peter Poonen.
Lads.
Yeah.
And Martin Mannion, who is Mo Dunford.
Marty. Okay.
Yes.
Marty, Doggy, Daddy.
And as... what a family. The Mannions. And as mentioned, Charlie Murphy's character Sarah interacts with all of them. She's married to... Daddy, and she's had dealings in the past with the other two.
I love that, like, this is absolutely fine to say because it's the character name.
Yeah. And how she plays the role is great because it's almost like three different performances, how she interacts with all the different sons and the father. And she's excellent in it. Coming out of it, I thought she'd be great for like a Bond femme fatale type definitely. Kind of remind me of Sophie Marceau and kind of the world's end of that kind of like condescending, like just fierce look throughout the film. She's great in it. And yeah, her character is great. And here's Daddy talking about Sarah.
Yeah. Well, yeah, right? she shapeshifts a little bit, yeah. Definitely to fit it.
I was bought into it at one second.
You really were. We're married.
We can't talk about that.
No, you're the best husband I've ever had. Yeah, I really go to town on you. I'm sorry. But yeah, she's a caretaker, unfortunately, all of the Mannion men.
She's a brilliant character.
Oh, she's a great character.
She is a great character. I remember reading it first thinking that she was kind of being hard done by. And then she turns out to be a very strong individual. Yeah. You know, it's a wonderful female character.
So yeah, two very, very good characters. But a lot of us would know, as you said, Charlie Murphy from Love Hate. And for me,
Eddie Murphy's brother
too. Mm-hmm. And as much as Pat Short's done some really good stuff, like he's been the guard, he's great in Garage. If anyone's seen Garage, just seriously check it out. You'd never think it was the same person, but I still always see him as Tom from Father Ted, just because like I was raised with that show. And there's a moment in this though, there's a scene, I won't say it in too much, where you will definitely think of Pat Short in a completely different light. And it kind of in a roundabout way came up before this clip and they were like laughing it off. But Pat brought it back to a very famous moment from Father Ted, which Justine will know, which is like, can you believe me, your own dog did that to me? So here they are talking about why his father mightn't have been too impressed with his debut on Father Ted.
Don't give it away. Don't give
Cut that.
We try and avoid it that ourselves.
That wasn't even in the script. Yeah. That was just a late
something
lunch.
We came up with.
That's just an outtake. Oh, Jan's the bonus eggs on this DVD are going to be something else. 18's rated from Roscommon.
I was doing an interview recently where I was talking, my first time on television was in Father Ted, and I had to drop my trousers and go, look at that fatter. My own dog did that to me. Doesn't it look like a face? And it was the first time I was on TV and my dad was watching it in a hotel in Wales. He wasn't that impressed. He's definitely not going to be impressed with this movie.
I don't think my parents are either.
I think it's testament that you can look each other in the eye and you're still friendly terms after something like that.
It's in our contract.
The two of them, I know, Paul, obviously you're really funny and you make them laugh a lot.
Yeah,
but the two of them seem to get on like brilliantly well and have the crack together. So it was a good chemistry between them and the other lads in the film as well.
Oh, it's great. Like it's one of those dark comedies kind of that we do really, really well. Like the Ian Bruges, like there's some great one-liners in it, but it's a really dark film about like grief and despair and kind of how Irish people are really bad at talking about it. But then you also have people like lines like, oh, he's got a head like a boiled ham, so like you can't take it too seriously. It's very got that kind of cutting jet black streak through it. It is very good. The trailer is gas. You'll see a lot of the one-liners. I thought it was very funny. I do think though, because the writer Kevin Barry is from a playwright background, I think it comes a bit too obsessed with words, and there's a voiceover throughout it, and it gets very, I wouldn't say highfalutin, but it just needs to tell the story cinematically as opposed to kind of the off-screen narration. This being said, it does look great. It's shot really well. Performances are excellent. I mean, I think I'm getting to the level now and I can't think of a bad Mo Dunford performance I've seen. He's great in it. Peter Coonan's quite good. He kind of plays this maverick kind of weirdo, kind of lives in a trailer, doesn't come out. You have all these very larger-than-life characters. Pap Short and Charlie Murphy are great together. It's kind of a couple that hate each other but have to live together, but meanwhile she's kind of fluting around with the other two behind his back. It's really well acted, as I said. I really liked Charlie Murphy in it, but it just didn't really, all the pieces just didn't fit for some reason. And there's an angle with Tommy Tiernan in it who I love. It just doesn't really go anywhere or really add much to it, but I think it's definitely worth seeing. Just like the one-liners alone are great, and it has that kind of, as I said, that real like McDonagh-esque kind of let's examine the real underbelly of Ireland thing that does so well, but it's aiming for that, but it just falls a bit below. But there is still some stuff here to enjoy.
Brilliant. You were obviously chatting to them about loads of other stuff as well, so you can check out the full Paul's full chat with Pat Short and Charlie Murphy. It's up on JOE.ie. It's live right now up there on YouTube as well, because you were talking about a whole mixture of other things as well, obviously any like wee hints about the new series of Peaky Blinders?
Yeah,
maybe
she was coy because there's another Irishman directing it, Anthony Byrne, and he's already saying like I'm back filming next year.
Yeah,
but it hasn't
yeah.
been officially announced by the Beeb yet. And if you watch that, Charlie Murphy's character came back in the final episode and had a fairly prominent scene, so
yeah.
I'd imagine she'd be back. They're not okay. still going to lend her there. And yeah, Pat Shortt said he's like the busiest year in yeah. his life coming up next year if everything gets off the ground. So
yeah, in terms of movie making, he said that's going to be his busiest one yet. So lots of exciting stuff coming up for both of them. So Dark Lies Island is out in Irish cinemas this week. As we said, loads of releases to get through. Yeah, I don't know why. What else was Joker? That was it. Joker was out, and everyone was like, is Joker finished with? We're not going near that one. And then it's like this big splurge of other movies being released as well. So up next, we have a little sneak peek at one of the... Yeah, no, I'm a big fan of this movie's name. Shaun the Sheep. I was going to say Shaun of the Dead.
I thought you were going to say Showgirls.
Shaun the Sheep, Farmageddon. So here's a quick look at that before we hear Rory's review.
Shaun's back. But there's a new arrival in town.
Oh. Lula.
Who's a little alien. She's about to discover
oh.
that our world is pretty sweet.
Have we all seen the first one?
Yeah.
Well, oh, that was sheep for yes, was it?
I can't really do a good sheep noise.
Should have done that interview like as a sheep for the next 5 minutes.
A full interview. Yeah. Can you do a good sheep noise?
That's pretty
not too
bad. Decent, like.
Yeah. From a farming background.
So all right, so,
that.
Of course.
A lot of method.
Meh.
Not bad.
I think I might have been one of my best ones yet.
That's pretty good. I'm not.
Ah, come on.
You will do it.
Go on. Do the sheep noise.
Will you?
We should get Wooly over.
that would work. Crossover.
So can I talk about...
Paul, will you do the sheep noise?
Moo.
Perfect. All right. So, see, sheep can't talk, so I'm going to sit here silently.
What a shame on this.
Have you seen the first one?
Yes, love the first one.
No.
Shaun the Sheep is a work of genius. The TV series.
I used to love the series.
I've seen the TV show.
No, it is. It's like surprisingly for a film that like there's no words in, is you really just hold your attention for like I don't know less than an hour and a half anyway, and I imagine kids must love it.
Yeah,
absolutely love it. So I quite enjoyed the first one. The second one is more the same except there's an alien in it. So it's essentially the plot of E.T. But on the Shaun the Sheep farm.
That's like Abominable.
Abominable.
Last week.
Yeah.
So more E.T.
There's a very like cute kind of octopus looking E.T. thing. And it can do a perfect impression of anything it hears. So like you both there
like
with the sheep.
Like the sheep after three,
oh
one, two, three.
Perfect. Sounded like a goat though.
Jesus, it's getting a bit more goaty. That's pretty technical, all right.
I'm just saying. Zombie
film, we should have done Black Sheep as well. Some great deaths in that.
Yeah.
Here's another Shaun of the Dead.
So, yeah, like, if you like the first one, you'll absolutely like this one as well. There's loads of very clever visual gags for the adults in the audience. You'll pick up on a lot of movie references. But aside from that, there's just so much physical humour in it. And there has to be, because, again... Sheep don't talk. The alien doesn't talk. Even like the humans who are in it kind of just talk like, rrr, rrr, rrr. They don't say anything.
Like the farmers have, yeah.
Yeah, and then there's the dog who also doesn't talk when he is just trying to keep the sheep in place. But the sheep are trying to get the alien back to its spaceship so it can go back to space. It's very funny. And I think it has the single best burp joke in any movie I've ever seen. Which
best.
Is, yeah.
Strong, that's the best burp joke in any movie ever.
Yeah.
Holy moly.
No, I don't have a list of...
I was going to say... Like,
elsewhere in my top five, but like...
That's next week's big quest.
Yeah. There has to be a burp in there, doesn't
there?
But yeah, it's really, really funny. If you've got kids, they'll love it. Even if you don't, you'll still love it. So, if you are a kid at heart...
Ah, nice.
Or a sheep at heart. If you're a sheep at heart...
Or you have a heart.
So not
Paul. Well, you see, this is the thing, because I was going to say not you, but like, no, this is great that you actually enjoyed it.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see it. She said, Justine, the TV series was brilliant. The first, I remember when the first movie was released and people saw it, And it started getting all these brilliant reviews, and people were like, this is a silent movie masterpiece, essentially, just with like the sound effects and everything as well. But the visual humor, it's Aardman, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah. I think they like Early Man was fine, but it wasn't that funny, I didn't think.
No.
Like it was grand, but it was like, I can do better than that, can't I?
Yeah. So, and Shaun the Sheep is so lovable as a character as well, and all the. And all the other like little sheepy characters as well.
They're sheep.
Yeah.
Sheep-like
characters. Something pretty sheepy about them.
Sheepish.
But yeah, so no, that's a good recommendation. Happy days. We'll all be going to see that. Shaun the Sheep. Shaun the Sheep. Shaun.
Still punching down.
The Sheep. That was an accident. Farmageddon, which is a great name as well.
Yes. Farmageddon's fantastic. Yeah. It's okay. That's,
oh, and you're not going to pull the wool over our eyes with that one.
Imagine being the person who came up with it first.
You're not here, Paul, no.
No.
You're just like zoned out or whatever.
She was whatever it was
puns
the right.
He was saying he made another wool pun. Yeah.
Oh,
but
no.
No, it's fine.
Is it best I don't
it.
Hear it?
Yeah, it's fine.
It didn't knit together.
I don't know. I didn't think it was too bad.
Pun combined with amazing sheep impression.
I needed a reason. Good.
Oh, wow. Right, just going to move on now because we've got nowhere else to go on that one. There's another brand new release coming out this week. Oh, there's loads of releases, basically. The next one up is Official Secret starring Keira Knightley. Can you do a Keira Knightley impression? Somebody just do a sheep noise. But yeah, let's take a quick look at a brand new movie in which he plays somebody who works for the government but is, I'm purely guessing here looking at the trailer. Okay. It would be easier if I asked you because you've seen the movie.
I can tell you after the clip if you want.
That could be a good way to do it.
Oh yeah.
That sounds like a plan. Let's do that. Okay.
Someone in this building has betrayed their country. If you are found to have withheld information, you will be charged with a breach of the Official Secrets Act.
Catherine Gunn, who do you think might have leaked the Kozer email?
I've got something you need to see.
Who brought you this? Friend?
I was going to guess the plot to Official Secrets, but as everyone else rightly pointed out, it'd be better if we just ask the person who's gone to see the movie. Roy. What's the movie about?
It's about Official Secrets.
You haven't really said. That was going to be my guess.
You would have got it right now. No, yeah. Keira Knightley. It's based on a true story. Keira Knightley plays.
This happened to her in real life.
Plays. Plays. She's an actress,
oh
mate.
Oh my God.
Gotcha.
What a day.
So, I mean.
I don't know.
It's the erratic energy.
Oh, it's just, yeah.
I just. So she plays. She kind of almost a translator for the UK government, and she's made privy to certain information that the US and the UK are basically going to not falsify but kind of exaggerate information that will allow them to go to war in the Gulf. In the background, Saddam was like, I don't have any nuclear bombs, and they're like, yes, you do, we're gonna come find them. And there was never any evidence that they were ever there. So she comes across the information and she gives it to the papers. And that's basically Reese fans, Matt Smith, and who's the other guy?
Matthew Good.
They all work in, I think it's The Observer. And they break the story. But then the government are like, who leaked this? And the whole thing is like them still trying to investigate it while she is deciding whether to come forward and tell the world that she was the whistleblower. But the Official Secrets Act means that she like legally can't do that because of a rule that Margaret Thatcher made like when she was in power.
She
so,
didn't do anything wrong anyway.
She's real.
Big fan of Thatcher on, yeah?
Ding dong, the witch is dead. Anyway.
It's a naked gun.
It's a naked gun.
But copyright. Oh, I can't sing that either.
Please don't sue us.
So yeah, it's directed by Gavin Hood, who did Eye in the Sky, which was great.
And Sotsy,
brilliant.
Yeah.
And Sotsy, but also...
Wolverine Origins, wasn't it?
Yeah, the bad one.
The one where Wolverine loves oranges.
Yes. Okay. Origins.
You're really punching down.
I don't understand the jokes you're making.
I told you, I haven't eaten anything today. My brain is operating at about 37%.
This is 37%?
This is 37% operational.
Cripes. So yeah, so he can make this political stuff very, very good, very interesting, very entertaining. When it's focused on the newspaper stuff, it almost feels like it's striving to be All the President's Men, which is a really good compliment to give any kind of political newspaper journalism story. And all the actors in that are really, really good. When it's focused on Keira Knightley's bit, and she's just like, just constantly on the either on the verge of tears or crying, because the government's like, you go to prison. It's just that bit's not interesting at all. And then Ralph Fiennes is in it, but he pops up 20 minutes from the end. Right. And it just feels like he had 2 days off and was like, yeah, all right.
Yeah, come on. Every other British actor is in it, so yeah, I'll come along and be in it.
Was this Harry Potter? Are you all around for another Harry Potter? Yeah, so half of it is really, really good and half of it is just kind of a bit dull. But I would almost recommend going to see it because that's a bit of history that I knew a little bit about, but I wasn't fully informed of all the details and the people and like the huge kind of seismic after effects that her telling the truth actually had. She is good, but it's just her bits just aren't very interesting. But everything around it is good.
That's a pity considering, as you said, it is based on that true story and the ramifications of the story. And it's like, you're working with some pretty bonk. Probably one of those storylines when it came out at the time, he was like, well, you couldn't write this. Like, do you know what I mean? You're like, well, here it is. It's phenomenal. Similar to, I know Adam Driver is coming out in The Report as well, which is kind of, not like after this particular period of time, but around CAA and their operations over like kind of Guantanamo Bay and torture and all that kind of stuff. And the fact that there were these people behind the scenes who were like, none of this stuff is good. We shouldn't be doing it. And you're lying to everybody. So they are really fascinating stories. It's just a pity, especially with such a good cast as well, that it just didn't kind of deliver. That kind of, you expect to be thrilled by this like the whole way through.
Yeah, and some of it is like, it is mostly good, but it just, there are some bits where you're like, I almost wish they had just focused on the newspaper bit. After she could have just been like, where you go? And then just left her over for the rest of it, but
like pass the story over to them.
Yeah, right, and just focused on their investigative stuff because, yeah, it's just a bit too dour.
Okay.
And it's just like, yeah, okay, get it. It's sad.
Okay, so Official Secrets out this week. Last but not least, the moment we've all been waiting for. It is, of course, Zombieland Double Tap.
I really thought you were going to say Shaun the Dead. Shaun the Dead, yeah.
Am I that predictable? I thought you were going to say it again.
I didn't.
So.
Thank you, Justine. Yeah.
Film inspired by Shaun the Dead.
Yeah. So when was Zombieland released?
2009.
Yeah,
long ago.
And what are we now?
2019.
1-9. Okay.
Well, they've already said they want to do another one 10 years from now.
That's right, actually. That would be phenomenal.
This is their Before Sunset, Before Sunrise.
Yeah. What a romantic trilogy. So we've got Woody Harrelson, Emma Thompson. Emma Stone.
The other one.
Yeah, exactly. Her daughter. Yeah, Jesse Eisenberg.
That's how it works.
And
Abigail Breslin.
Abigail Breslin. Where's Abigail Breslin been? What's she been up to?
Watching Zombieland.
Yeah, just getting ready for this one. Okay, fair enough. Okay, so here's a little look at Double Tap.
Welcome to Zombieland. Life is about more than just survival. We were a family. Dysfunctional, sure, but what family isn't?
Merry Christmas! What would you like, little girl?
I'd really like for you to stop calling me little girl.
But do you know what I would like?
I don't give a shit what you...
It felt so good to be on the move again.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry. Hi, I'm Columbus.
Madison.
This is Tallahassee.
Hey, Paul Blart. Is this your dad?
Oh, whoopsie, I forgot the seatbelt rule.
Oh, so she knows the rules?
I told her just a few of them.
73, and are there more?
You're cute.
I like it.
So yeah, the gang are back. We've got Columbus, which is Jesse Eisenberg, Tallahassee, Woody Harrelson, Little Rock, Abigail Breslin, and Ohio, I think, is Emma Stone's character. Yes. Mm-hmm. So we pick up 10 years after, and it starts, get there early. I'll say this because there's a great, even pre-credits gag, a title gag that's in there early.
Wasn't that one of the brilliant things about Zombieland as well? That whole opening, because they were going through the rules of Zombieland as Jesse Eisenberg was getting chased around. It was just really nicely done, the way like the graphics were appearing on screen. So it's good they've kept that kind of going.
Get your Omniplex cinema, get your big popcorn, get a good seat, because even before you even see the production cards, there's a great one for this studio. And it opens really well. There's one brilliant, you get caught up to speed. The guy's just kicking ass, headshots galore. soundtrack to Master Puppets, and I was like, I am pumped, absolutely pumped. So first 15 minutes to get into the story, basically the gang are all together, but they're getting a bit bored, a bit kind of isolated in Zombieland because, you know, everyone's gone. They're all zombies. We're introduced to some new types of zombies. Remember in the last one they had like the slow ones and the ones you have to be careful of. So there's a new breed of zombies. But people are getting a bit frustrated now because Columbus, Jesse Eisenberg, is getting a bit pushy with the girlfriend Emma Stone, and obviously they're her and Little Rock are sisters. And Tallahassee is kind of, Woody Harrelson's getting a bit imposing on a father figure. So the gang split up. They split up, I know. And then, we're into the crux of the story. You got the two girls on a road trip, two guys, and you'd expect violence and danger. Then for about half an hour, you're kind of, there's no real zombie kill fest action. And you're kind of like, I need a headshot. Particularly after the start, you're pumped and you're ready to go. And it just sort of, it goes a bit flat. But then it comes back in, we're introduced to Rosario Dawson's in there. She's a new character called Nevada. They really love the States.
Love Rosario Dawson.
She's great. She's phenomenal. Yeah.
She's really good in this.
She should be way more prominent in everything.
Yeah, Rosario Dawson needs to be used in a lot more films because she's one of the best things about Daredevil as well. She's like just super actor.
And Sin City.
And what would you know? She's one of the best things about this too. She's great.
Oh, really?
New Happy character days. Called Nevada. So basically, the girls are on one way, the boys on the other. Little Rock, Abigail Breslin, meets a new character called, you saw in the trailer, Berkeley, who's this kind of liberal hippie stoner who doesn't believe in violence, even against zombies. So she kind of goes under his wing and, hey, there's no one in the world, so our choice first meal.
Luke Wilson?
No. He's kind of one of Tallahassee's rivals for the heart of Rosario Dawson, because everyone loves her. Everyone loves her. So basically, Abigail Breslin goes off on one adventure, ends up in this kind of hippie commune that's like a safe haven for the zombies to get reunited. But what would you know? The new zombies just keep wanting to eat. Just want those brains.
That's what zombies do.
That's what they want.
Classic zombie behavior.
Relatable content.
I like this in parts, but it just wasn't gory enough for me. Okay. And like, I know even Zombieland, I loved it because it had the Looney Tunes violence. They even bring back like, you know, the zombie killer of the week. And even some of them weren't as funny as the first one. I didn't think it really kicked on an awful lot. And you know, they're like the rule number one, cardio, rule number 32, never enter a batch on your own. Yeah, they brought back that gag and it was funny, but they kept doing it. I was like, there wasn't an awful lot of originality to it. It was like, and when it's funny, there's a few laugh moments, but like, you really have to know the first one. Let's say if I was coming into this fresh and didn't say it, I'd be like, I don't really know what they're talking about. Obviously, if you know the first one, you go to it again. But yeah, it felt a bit flat for me for this long, for 10 years, that there wasn't an awful lot of new stuff they were bringing to it. This being said, as I said, the first 15 minutes are great. Kind of goes down, and then it picks up for the even finale. But even by then, I was kind of like, I don't really care as much as I should. But there is a wonderful post-credit gag, so don't leave.
Is it pre and post?
Yeah, post-credit, so stick around.
Just a bit in the middle could have been slightly better. just a little bit in the middle.
Before the credits and after. Yeah.
Like, it's fun seeing them all together.
Yeah.
It just should have been so much more fun. It just felt a bit flat.
Do you remember, it sounds like Deadpool 2.
Kind of, yeah.
These wrote as well. You know, like, it's like, oh, it's the same, but for some reason it's not.
Yeah, you laugh at one of the gags and they go back and like do it again and again because there's a new character and she's, the name escapes me, a blonde, and she's like, oh, I'm an airhead. And like, they make fun of it once, like, oh, a zombie wouldn't eat her, she's no brains. Ha ha, that's funny. But then they just keep kind of hammering her bones, like, you can move on a bit more.
Almost like the writing's just a wee bit lazy.
Yeah, but it flies by in 90 minutes, but I just, like, even as a car, it needed more gore.
Yeah.
Like, it really needed more.
What about, there's a bit in the trailer as well, whenever you said, like, Luke Wilson pops up and it appears that there's, like, a Woody Harrelson double, played by Luke Wilson, and a Jesse Eisenberg double as well, which feels... I don't want to bring it up again, but, like, Shaun of the Dead as well, whenever they meet, like, they're identical versions of themselves in another group as well.
Basically, whenever Woody Harrelson's on screen, it's a lot of fun. Because you know, like, he goes, like, full Woody Harrelson, like, bonkers. Like, there's a trip to Graceland, and there's all that stuff, and it's a lot of fun. But just, it's not enough. And I loved the first one, because it felt like the Looney Tunes on screen. But, yeah, definitely worth seeing, just for sheer the love of seeing them, but like, could have been a bit more.
Okay. Well, so we look forward to the one in 10 years' time then, the third one. Mm-hmm. Okay, perfect. Rounded off in style. So you've got Dark Lies the Island, Zombieland, Double Tap, Shaun of the Sheep. Oh my God! Shaun the Sheep.
I actually don't think he...
Farmageddon.
I don't think you were joking. I think that
no,
was
I wasn't no, joking then, not. And I wasn't joking the last time either.
Because he couldn't be that funny if you tried.
Oh, that hurt.
Yeah, too, Paul.
Cut so deep. And then what was the other one that was out?
Zombie
Official
Spiel.
Secrets. Official Secrets. We're not allowed to talk about that one, though. Okay, so loads to choose from. And still the best of the rest. You've jokers out there making an absolute fortune at the Irish box office. It looks like it's destined to become one of the biggest hits of the year here in Ireland as well. Right, now it's time for some tickets to give away. So we started giving away these tickets last week. We'll have some more this week and next week as well. In the run-up to Halloween, we're going to be celebrating the release of Stephen King's Doctor Sleep. Now, have any of you read that book?
Yeah.
No. I have not.
Did you like it?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I've seen the film, if that helps.
You've seen the film?
Yeah.
You've already seen it?
Yeah.
He can't talk about it.
I can't talk about it, yeah.
More Official Secrets. We will have a full review of it coming up in future weeks.
It's weird they played Shaun the Dead, though, I thought.
but yeah, so what's your... Do you want to tell us just a wee rundown of the plot, basically, without reviewing it?
Danny Torrance from The Shining.
Mm-hmm. The wee boy.
Grows up.
Yeah.
He can still shine. But he doesn't want to. However, there are people that want to steal his shine, nefarious types.
Okay.
Who feed and live off this soul and light that they have. However, there's someone who's more powerful than Danny, but he's turned away from his ability and he has to protect them against these horrible, horrible beings. And all things lead, I'm not going to say.
Okay.
Because it's The Shining.
To the ending.
To your nearest Omniplex cinema where you can go and check it out.
Very smooth.
Danny, growing up, Danny is played by
Mr. Ewan McGregor. And you got Rebecca Ferguson in there leading this group of...
She's super.
She's actually very good in this as well. No, it's really, really good. And Mike Flanagan directed it, who did a great one on Netflix called Hush, and he's also known for The Haunting of Hill House.
Brilliant. So he's coming in with good pedigree anyway. So yes, Dr. Sleep, we've got tickets to give away to the Irish premiere, which is coming up in the next few weeks. And all you have to do to be in with a chance of winning those tickets is get the answer to our High Clue right, and we will be selecting some winners. So in the latest High Clue, can we see it up on screen, please? This is from last week. It was Cuba versus Japan, Cuba v Japan, Zoolander's presidential, best friends click with nurse. So in the first line, Cuba v Japan, just the letter V. That stands for versus. In the middle line, Zoolander's presidential, Zoolander apostrophe S. And the final line, best friends click with nurse. Loads of right answers online, but any ideas here in the studio? Yes. Yeah. Rory, you have an idea?
I put this to the back of my mind, probably because of the versus controversy. I haven't worked it out. I've got about two different films. See, Zoolander's presidential, I just thought Trump, because he cameoed in Zoolander.
Right, so okay.
And then Best Friends, Click, I thought Click, the Adam Sandler film, and isn't Jennifer Aniston in Click as well? Oh, I'm thinking, no. So I don't get it.
That long story short, pretty much on the, like, on the right track.
You've got
ideas?
The film hints, but you haven't got the...
Film, yeah. And Cuba, I thought Cuba Gooding. I've got like loads
that's
of the
films. Yeah, 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 I would have put that for him.
Cuba Gooding Jr.
And when, Japan Gooding Jr.
When was Cuba Gooding?
Cuba Gooding Jr.
When was he fighting Japan?
It's not Jerry Maguire.
He wasn't fighting Japan.
Yeah, I was thinking, yeah, like, when did he fight
in the NFL?
Tell me, because it's on the screen.
Well, he'll tell you because he says
snow
so.
Dogs? Yes.
Yeah. Snow dogs. Well, the answer is, drum roll. Can we see the answer, please? Pearl Harbor. Yeah. So I want to say a huge congratulations to Keelan Boyce, whose profile pic, really cool. It's the Joker dancing. Or maybe it's a picture of
him dancing.
Keelan Boyce, yeah. And just looks really like Joaquin Phoenix.
Nice.
Keelan, are you the Joker?
There's hopefully loads not. Of Phoenixes. He could be.
Hopefully like, not. Like, yeah, this is true. So, yes, congratulations to Keelan Boyce. You'll get yourself a pair of tickets to go along to the Irish premiere of Stephen King's Doctor Sleep. So, can we get a look at the High Clue again? We'll just do a quick breakdown of it. It was Cuba v Japan. Cuba, not the country. It was Cuba Gooding Jr. He plays one of the Marines in it as well when he's fighting the Japanese as they attack Pearl Harbor. Zoolander's presidential was John Voight. Who plays Zoolander's daddy?
Oh, yeah.
Ah.
In Zoolander. And he's also the president, Roosevelt, in Pearl Harbor as well. So it's a presidential version of him. And the final line, best friends click with Nurse. It was Click, the movie, and the female lead was played by Kate Beckinsale.
Oh, you're right.
She's the nurse in Pearl Harbor, and the best friends click with her because they both fall in love with her, Josh Hartnett and Ben Affleck as well. So all together, Pearl Harbor. Sweet.
It's a good one.
It's
a good one.
I remember being so excited about that film whenever it was coming out.
Me?
Because of the shot in the trailer with the bomb.
But that was the best bit.
Yeah.
And then the rest of the film was on.
Yeah.
The Pearl Harbor bit is good.
The big attack scene. There were some brilliant shots. Of course, it was directed by Michael Bay as well. When the boys are just out playing on the hill and the planes are just like kind of silently going past them as well. There's some good stuff in there, but I haven't seen it in years now.
If he's making it now, he'd probably put a transformer in there.
Yeah.
I'm back to watch that.
That's what
yeah.
it was missing.
I would watch that.
Oh no, Michael Bay, you're going to make that film, aren't you? He really is. So that was last week's High Clue. Now it's time for, you guessed it, this week's High Clue. So let's get a quick look. It's Bullish Kent's King's Bond, Made to Take Hands in Marriage, Fights Christian Brother. So the three lines again. Bullish Kent's King's Bond, Made to Take Hands in Marriage, Fights Christian Brother. So in the first line, Bullish Kent's is with a capital K, and it's T apostrophe S. Mm. King's, what? what was that moan? Was my tummy or Palmer's moan? King's is King apostrophe S as well. The middle line, Made to Take Hands in Marriage, Hands is H-A-N-S with a capital H. And the final line, Fights Christian Brother, Christian with a capital C.
I've redeemed myself in the space of 90 seconds because I think I have it.
You think you have that one? Yeah. Okay. Do you want to jot it down and scribble it and see?
Do I have my pen?
Rory, do you think you've got it as well? He's also scribbling. Justine, what about this syllable count? Where are we on that?
Oh, we're checking him out.
Sorry, nice.
Yeah, we're in agreement.
Yes.
Yeah.
And you've gone for the same one then as well, okay? Yeah. Justine, have you gone for the same one?
Checks out. I was just doing the syllables.
Oh. 5-7. Justine's
busy. Yeah, busy.
We both think snow dogs.
Did they get the same answer?
Snow dogs again. Yeah.
We both said Shaun the Dead.
Perfect.
To bring it back around.
Can you imagine?
The irony. I'm definitely going to have to.
If that had been, like, seriously.
That would have been spooky.
It almost like we planned this stuff and like almost like
it was all organized. So best of luck with that one, everybody. Keenan Boyce, you don't need to enter, but feel free to if you want. You'll only win once, though. Name that James Bond film. So we'll put that up online as well. Coming up soon on next week's show. Oh, it's going to be a Terminator special because we're going to have none other than Gabrielle Luna on the show.
And not also, to mention.
Mackenzie Davis.
Anyone else in those films?
I've heard enough because I love those two people. Linda Hamilton.
Yeah.
Pretty impressive.
It's good. Sarah Connor, man.
How do we top that?
Arnold Schwarzenegger's going to be here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Right here.
Not right here.
The same seat that Lou Ferrigno filled. No. But he will be on the show.
He definitely will be on the show next week. It's our Darminator. It's our Terminator Dark Fate special, so we can look forward to that one. Anything else do we need to get out?
Is that not enough?
I think that should be plenty.
Plenty.
You've got Arnie Schwarzenegger, what more do you want? Please do subscribe to the show, that'll be much appreciated, and leave those reviews as well, only the positive ones, because if you leave a negative one, we will come to your house and kill you.
Like the Terminator.
Jesus.
Too much?
God, fears.
Okay, we'll come to their house, full stop.
For tea.
Show you, to tell you why it's a good show.
Yeah.
Brilliant. That is exactly
That's
what
less we're doing.
Yeah, okay. Everyone want to do a bye? A bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. See you later. We'll have to watch Shaun of the Dead.
Of course we are. Yeah.